Hi, my name is Ramya and I am a PhD student in chemical engineering. I will be telling you about how sugary polymers can help us understand viral infections. Have you ever wondered why you sometimes fall sick despite getting a flu shot? The answer could lie in studying a forest of sugar chains that surround our cells, the glycocalyx. Glyco means sugar and calyx means shell. So the glycocalyx is simply a sugar shell that surrounds our cells and keeps us safe from viral infections. It is a gatekeeper that decides what can enter the cell and what stays out. How do viruses manage to outwit the glycocalyx and infect us? Viruses have to bind to the glycocalyx in order to enter our cells, but we need to carry out experiments to understand what makes the virus attach to the glycocalyx. Typically, scientists do this by growing cells in the lab and by examining the glycocalyx as it is found in the body. But this is very hard because the glycocalyx collapses when you take it out of the body and put it under a microscope. So studying the glycocalyx in its natural form is very complicated. A way around this problem is to turn to man-made materials to mimic the glycocalyx. In my lab, we use polymer coatings as an artificial glycocalyx. What is a polymer? Polymers are simply long molecules made by linking up many small molecules in a repeating pattern. Our polymer is a long chain of sugar molecules. The polymer coating is like shrink wrap. It is an extremely thin and transparent film. Why are we using polymers? Polymers are the Swiss Army knife of the material science world. A Swiss Army knife can have any attachment you want, as many attachments as you want, and each attachment can do a different job, whether it's opening a can of beans or cutting up rope. Likewise, polymers are very versatile. A polymer coating has to multitask because the glycocalyx is a multitasker. The glycocalyx can be compared to a bouncer at a nightclub. If you think about the bouncer's first job, he has to recognize people who have the right tickets to enter the club. In the glycocalyx, this ticket checking is done by a receptor that recognizes molecules with a ticket. The bouncer's second job is to be a barrier and close doors to people who don't have tickets and shouldn't be let inside the club. On the glycocalyx, this barrier role is played by sugar chains that ripple viruses that shouldn't be inside our cells. So we make polymer coatings that can have different sugar chains and different receptors and study how viruses behave on these coatings. What we have observed so far is that some viruses are sophisticated enough to actually hijack the ticket checking part and to gain entry. It's a little bit like printing counterfeit tickets and tricking the bouncer. One way to avoid this is by having a sufficiently dense sugar barrier. Our polymer surface helps us look at how different receptors and different sugar chains can affect virus binding, giving us clues to design countermeasures against infection. We can study different viruses, right from the ones that give you the flu to the ones that cause Ebola. We hope that what we can learn from these experiments will help us understand virus binding a lot better. The story of how viruses attach to our cells in our body is a bittersweet story, but maybe we'll have a happy ending thanks to polymers that can sugarcoat the answer for us. Thanks for watching.